you are a potential state captor, you may find Serbian defense sector enticing for two reasons. First, because it comprises some elements such as military police or military security and intelligence services, which could of course be used for strengthening political power, for instance, by intimidating political opponents or conducting surveillance over them. At the same time, it's out of those three parts of the security sector, it's the one wielding most resources, especially given that the largest arms manufacturers in Serbia are actually publicly owned enterprises. Also, we have a trend of increasing defense expenditure in Serbia. So, for instance, between 2015 and 2019, Serbian defense expenditures more than doubled, which means there is a huge potential for extracting resources, especially if you consider that, unlike, for instance, in construction sector, here you have a special perk of being able to conceal everything by using national security interests as justification. Now, what are specific mechanisms facilitating state capture processes in defense sector of Serbia? I will highlight three. The first one is systematic undermining of transparency through changes in regulation, from internal regulation to government bylaws to legislation at national level. The second mechanism is actually the detrimental combination of strengthening discretionary powers of the Minister of Defense and informal decision making. The third mechanism is actually weakening civilian control of the armed forces. Yes, in Serbia we do have civilian control of the armed forces, but it's only political control. While at the same time the power of civil servants, which was delicate enough, has been shrinking, and the best evidence for this is the fact that the highest rank civil servant positions in the Ministry of Defense, those of deputy ministers, have been either vacant or filled with temporary personnel for years now.